www.punarvasi.com is my website. I used to write different step-by-step procedures on SAP basis administration in my website. Many people got benefited from my articles. You can also browse my articles to gain some knowledge in different technologies. My name is Mr. Raz. I am SAP Basis NetWeaver International Trainer. I have total IT experience of 18 years, 3 months. My qualification is MSc IT and Special Diploma in Electronics with Specialization in Communication Engineering. I have done CCNA certification and MCP certification. So this is my website, that is www.punarvasi.com, and this is the page for my private list of videos on SAP basis administration, basis videos, and here you can click on this link to watch my channel, YouTube channel. You can watch some free demo videos. And in this video, I'll show you how to install SAP NetWeaver 7.0 EHP1 Enhancement Pack 1 Central System. Central system means database instance, central instance, and front-end software will be installed in single host machine, that is server. How do you install SAP NetWeaver? If you have a server, you can install SAP NetWeaver 7.0 EHP1 directly without using any virtualization software. If you don't have the server, install SAP NetWeaver 7.0 EHP1 within VMware Workstation. VMware Workstation is a software which will help you to install any other operating system on top of your host operating system. Do you have a desktop computer with server operating system? For suppose if you have a desktop computer where you can install server operating system, means the server operating system has the drivers, network drivers to install on your desktop, you can straight away install Windows Server 2008 on your desktop computer to install SAP NetWeaver 7.0 EHP1 directly. There is no need to use VMware Workstation software. And to install SAP NetWeaver 7.0 EHP1 within virtual machine, that is VMware Workstation, you need to have the BIOS which has VT option, that is virtualization technology. So when you switch on your computer or laptop, immediately you can enter into the BIOS so that you can view for this particular option and you can enable it. Once you enable that, you can install VMware Workstation on your computer, and then you can install Windows Server 2008 operating system within VMware Workstation as guest operating system on top of your host operating system, that may be Windows 7 or Windows 8 operating system. So there is no need to spoil your original operating system which comes along with the laptop or desktop. Okay, so that your computer BIOS should have the option VT virtualization technology. VT should be enabled to run virtual machine within VMware Workstation. Without VM option, you cannot install SAP NetWeaver 7.0 EHP1 within VMware Workstation. No VT option, you can install SAP NetWeaver EHP1 directly. If you don't have the VT option, you should install Windows Server 2008 directly on your desktop or laptop computer, and then you should install SAP NetWeaver 7.0 EHP1. And what are the hardware requirements to install SAP NetWeaver 7.1? You need to have 64-bit processor. You can have even i3 processor also. It is also 64-bit processor. i5, i7 are good for the installation of SAP systems or AMD processors. And you need to have 4 GB RAM for direct installation or 8 GB RAM for VMware. means if you want to install on top of VMware, you should have 8 GB RAM so that you can leave 4 GB RAM for your host operating system and 4 GB can be allocated to your guest operating system. And 100 GB or more HDD free space to install SAP NetWare software, you need to have something around 100 GB. You will have some free space also to work within, so that you better keep 100 GB. And 20 GB for installation files, means RAR files, and to extract the RAR files also you should have some space. Altogether it comes to 20 GB. And you can install SAP NetWare 7.0 VHP1 within a single drive, means you can have more than single drive to install. Even if you have only single drive also, there is no issue. You can straight away install SAP NetWare software within the single drive. And to extract installation files into virtual machine, means once the virtual machine is configured and installed Windows Server operating system, you can create separate drive for storing, means extracting the RAR files into that drive, so that the drive can be attached and detached whenever you want. And the software requirement, what are all the softwares that are needed to install SAP NetWare software are listed here. Those are VMware Workstation 8 or 9. It has to be installed on top of your Windows 7 or 8 operating system. Windows 8 doesn't support 9. You need to have VMware Workstation 10 to install on Windows Server, Windows 8 operating system. And Microsoft Windows Server 2008 CD DVD is required. That is, if you have .iso file also okay to install, means within the VMware Workstation you have the option to choose that particular file. And you should have the J2 SDK file and Oracle 10G for Windows Server 2008. Oracle 10G normally cannot be installed on top of Windows Server, but you can use the Oracle 10G which is separately available for Windows Server 2008. You can install on it. And Oracle 10G patch and installation master of the SAP NetWare software and kernel of the SAP NetWare software. Oracle client is required, and then SAP crypto file is required for SSL security, secure socket layer security, and SAP GUI for Windows, means after completion of the SAP NetWare software you should install SAP GUI for Windows. It will be used for logging into the SAP system. SAP NetWare 7.0 EHP1 folder, where I have copied all the required installation files to the single folder, and these folders consist of RAR files. I will show you how to extract these RAR files to the folder within VM, that is virtual machine. And the total size of this particular folder is 9.78 GB. And installing VMware Workstation, you have to start the VMware Workstation installation. You have to install VMware Workstation for installing on top of your existing client operating system, example Windows 7 or 8. This OS is called host OS or host computer. Windows 7 or 8 is called host OS, that is host computer. If you have server and you can install Windows Server OS on it, there is no need to install VMware. You can proceed all the remaining steps by treating as you are installing on a direct computer. I have installed this software within VMware Workstation so that you will see VMware within the next screens. Don't confuse between both types of installations. And from this folder, double click on this VM9.exe file so that the VMware Workstation installation will be started. And this same folder has the CD key also. Whenever it asks for the CD key, you have to enter. And the VMware Workstation installation is started. Click on the next button. And typical option. And click on the next button. And you will see some tick mark here that check for product updates on startup. Just remove that tick and click on the next. And this tick also remove and click on the next button. And the shortcut will be created on the desktop and start menu programs folder. Just accept the default and click next and continue. and the VMware installation will be finished. Click on the finish button to complete the installation. You will see the icon which is created on the desktop. Yeah, click on the finish and double click on the VMware workstation. And once you double click on the VMware workstation, you will see this screen. From here, click on the file, click on the new virtual machine, and you should select custom option. Click on the next. Hardware compatibility is VM workstation 9.0. Click on the next, and I will install the operating system later. So instead of choosing install a disk image for file, just choose third option. Click on the next and choose Microsoft Windows and Microsoft Server, Windows Server 2008 x64. Click on the next and name this virtual machine as SAP NW701. SAP NetWeaver 7.0 EHP1 denotes like this. 701 means 7.0 EHP1. And by default, this particular installation will goes into this particular folder, that is /users/RAS/documents/virtual machines SAP NW701. But suppose if you don't have the space, proper space within the C drive, if your host operating system or host computer has second drive, that is D:/E:, even external drive also you can use for this particular purpose of installation. You can choose the browse button here and you can choose that external drive for installing this particular virtual machine into the external drive directly. But what I will suggest you is that just accept the default. If you have the space 100 GB or 200 GB free space within the C drive, let the installation goes into the C drive. Once the installation is completely finished, then you can copy the .vmdk file from this location and you can store it on your external drive for later usages. Even you can use that particular .vmdk file as your backup, so that there is no need to start from the scratch. Wherever you want, you can take the backup of that particular file to start the installation from that point onwards. For suppose if you installed Oracle software and if you want to skip the Oracle installation for installing SAP NetWeaver software, you can use the backup copy of the after Oracle installation. Just I'll mention the point again once the Oracle installation is completed here. Okay, just click accept the default and click on the next button here. And number of processors 1, number of cores per processors 1. Just accept the default and click on next button and choose the RAM up to 4 GB. 4 GB is more than enough for the SAP NetWeaver installation. Even 2 GB also sufficient for this particular installation. If it is a ECC software, you should compulsorily have 4 GB. In the case of SAP NetWeaver, you can choose 2 GB. But suppose if you are planning for three system landscape, three times if you want to install SAP NetWeaver, you can choose 2 GB here and 2 GB for second system, 2 GB for third system. Means 3 times you can install SAP NetWeaver software for 3 system landscape. But in this video, just I am showing you only 1 system installation. Once you understand how to install 1 SAP system, you can install second and third systems in the same way. Okay, click on the next button and use bridged networking. You should choose this particular option to get the network properties of your host operating system. Whatever the IP address is there in the host operating system, same series of IP address will be allocated to your guest operating system also. Click on the next button and accept the default, that is LSI Logic SAS. Click on the next button and create a new virtual disk. Means freshly it will create the virtual disk here. Click on the next button and select a disk type. SCSI is recommended. Click on the next and maximum disk size, that is 100 GB I have chosen. Just 40 GB actually the by default value, just I have changed it to 100 GB. If you are planning all 3 systems in single VMware, you can choose more than this space, like 200 or 250 GB you can choose, so that you can install 3 SAP systems within the single VM. If you are planning to install 3 SAP systems separately, you can choose 100 GB for this particular SAP network system. Okay, and allocate all disk space. Now if you choose this option, what will happen is 100 GB will be allocated now itself. There is no need to allocate the complete space right now. Just remove that tick and store virtual disk as a single file. Means the entire installation will be stored as single .vmdk file, so that you can copy the .vmdk file to separate location for the purpose of backup. And click on the next button here. And the file name is like this, that is sapnw701.vmdk. Click on the next, and new virtual machine wizard, it is completed, it is final screen, click on the finish, so that the virtual machine will be created. You can see the option here in the left hand side. Okay, once it is done, just I came here to show you the folder where it is stored, that is RAS documents virtual machines SAP NW701. Here this is the file, that is SAP NW701.vmdk file. The size of that particular file is, right click on that particular file and click on the properties, so that you can view the size of the file. Even though you chosen 100 GB there, it is just showing 12.5 MB only, because the file size will grow as and when you are installing some stuff inside the VM. Okay, just go to the next screen. That is VMware workstation screen. As I said, you will see the option in the left hand side, that is SAP NW701, and choose the CD or DVD option to specify the .iso file of Windows Server 2008 operating system. Click on this option so that you can choose the ISO file, use ISO image file. Click on the browse button to choose it, Microsoft Windows Server 2008. I have browsed to the location of all the files located, that is F:\backup:\new:\HP1:\NW701.SR1. Just choose the Microsoft Windows Server 2008 and click on the open, and that file will come here. Just click on the OK button so that the virtual machine is ready along with the ISO file, that is DVD disk within the CD drive, means DVD drive. So now ready to start the virtual machine, that is power on this virtual machine. Click on this option to start the virtual machine. So because the ISO file is inside, so that the Windows Server 2008 installation will be started automatically. Means the virtual disk which you have configured, it is empty, nothing is installed in that. Okay, now I am installing Windows Server 2008. Just click on means next screen. Just it is the first screen after starting with the DVD. Click on the next and click on the install now button, so that the Windows Server 2008 will be installed. Just go to the next screen and choose the option Windows Server 2008 64-bit edition. Click on the next, and I accept the license terms. Click on the next and click on the custom option, and this is the hard drive we have chosen, that is 100 GB. Select the hard drive, click on the next, and the installation will be started, and it will be finished within 5 to 10 minutes time. And this is the screen to choose some third party softwares. Just remove all the ticks and click on the exit button. There is no need to install any third party softwares. And click on the OK button here. First time you have to change the password of the Windows Server 2008, and provide the password and repeat the password, and click on the enter button, and the password has been changed. Click OK, and this is the first screen you will get once Windows Server 2008 is booted, that is initial configuration tasks. Just choose this option, do not show this window at logon, and click on the close button, and one more window will be opened, that is server manager. This also does not require now. Just select this option, do not show this show me this console at logon. Just close the button here, and this is the networking settings screen. Here just click on the work option and click on the close button, and the Windows Server 2008 desktop will be displayed like this, and the network connection is proper. That's why you are able to see this icon here, means the internet connection is available within the VM also, means you can browse the internet from the VM. That's why the networking requirement for installing SAP NetWeaver software is fulfilled. If you don't have this particular networking option, you should install Microsoft Loopback Adapter. In this case, there is no need to install the Microsoft Loopback Adapter. Microsoft Loopback Adapter is just nothing but it is a dummy network adapter which will act as a networked computer. You have to provide the IP address also manually to the Microsoft Loopback Adapter. In this case, the network is proper, so that there is no need to install Microsoft Loopback Adapter. And Windows Server 2008 screen is little bit small, means the mouse movement also will be very slow, so that you have to install the VMware tools within this system. So here you will have the option to install the tools. Just click on the install tools, the tools will be installed automatically. That is this type of screen you will see, and click on this option, that is run setup 64.exe. So click on the next, click on the next, click on the install, so that the VMware workstation tools will be installed in few seconds. And once you get this screen, click on the finish, and it will ask you to restart the computer, means virtual machine will be restarted, and it will comes to this stage, that is control alt delete to log on. So your keyboard normally takes the input by host operating system if you press control alt delete. So to get the control alt delete option within this particular VM, you have to click within the VM and press control alt insert from your keyboard, or you have the option to choose from here, that is VM send control alt delete, so that the control alt delete command will goes to the VM, that is virtual machine, and provide the password, click on the enter button, so that the window will come like this. And now click on the view and click on the fit guest now, click on the fit guest now, so that the window will looks like this. And now the performance will be better than earlier, that is before installing VMware tools and after installing VMware tools, you will feel the difference. And this is the Windows Server 2008 operating system desktop screen. Click on next, go to the next screen. Now click on the VM, click on the settings, and click on the add button, and click on the hard drive, and click on the next. What it is doing is, I am creating another hard drive for extracting installation files from the host operating system to guest operating system. Means in my host operating system, I have all the installation files in the RAR format. I have to extract those RAR files into the VM. And if you have the separate hard disk, what is the main advantage is that this hard disk can be detached from this VM and can be used within any other VM for installation directly without extraction again. Means if you are planning to install SAP NetWeaver software second time, you can use this particular hard drive, that is VMDK file, and you can attach it to the second VM. Okay, so for that purpose, I am creating the second hard drive. Click on the next, create a new virtual disk, click on the next, and SCSI drive, click on the next, and again 100 GB I have chosen here, and store virtual disk as a single file, so that the 100 GB will be there. Up to this 100 GB it will grow. And again, I am not allocating complete disk space now. I have removed the tick from here. Click on the next. And this is the file name, that is SAP NW701-0.vmdk file. Click on the finish button. Okay, click on the OK. And now the hard drive is created, but it should be initialized properly to make use of it. So that right click on the computer, click on the manage, and select the storage. Expand the storage, select the disk management. Here in this is the hard drive which we have created just now. right click here, click on the online, means it is in offline. You should make it as online, and once it is online, you should again right click on this particular option, means disk 1, and click on the initialize disk, so that the disk will be initialized and it is ready for use. Means like this you will get, and click on the OK button. Now you need to create the simple volume by right clicking on this particular space, right click here and click on the new simple volume, and this is the simple volume wizard. Click on the next and choose complete size, that is complete like 100 GB, and click on the next and assign the following drive letter. E drive will be assigned to this particular volume, and click on the next, and the format this particular drive using NTFS, and select perform a quick format so that the drive will be formatted quickly. Click on the next, click on the finish, and it is already formatted. There is no need to format again, just click on the cancel button to cancel this particular operation. Okay, so once it is done, just you will see this type of E drive within your computer. Double click on the computer, you will get this screen and just see this E drive. Okay, within the E drive, what I did is I have created a folder called SAP NW701. Within this folder, I am going to extract all the files from my host operating system to guest operating system. So here is the procedure. Just I am selecting the shared folder from the host operating system where I have stored all RAR files. Again, this is the procedure to connect to shared folders of my host operating system. Even you can access the files and folders from the network, but it is better to have the shared folder. So within the VM as map network drive, that is Z drive will be created now. Okay, choose VM and click on the settings and click on the options, selected folders, shared folders, and choose the option always enabled, map as a network drive in Windows guest. Select that and click on the add button and click next and browse it and choose the host path, that is where you have stored all RAR files. Okay, and the name of that particular folder, automatically it will come. Just accept the defaults, click on the next button and enable this share, and it is read only, means nothing will be corrected from the host operating system if you put this read only option. And just we will use all these files and folders for extraction purpose, that's why read only permission is sufficient. Click on the finish and click on the OK button and click on the computer so that you can see the Z drive like this. You see, this is network shared folders from the VMware host operating system, and this is E:, the folder which I have created. Now double click on this particular Z drive, and so that all the folders and files will be displayed like this, and one by one you extract from your host operating system to the VM, that is guest operating system. Double click on the exports, and this is the major folder, means it will be used for the importing all the table information into the database, and extract all and choose the path like this, that is E:\SAP NW701/exports. Within this particular folder, the exports folder will be created. And I have left this option, show extracted files when complete, means once the extraction is completed, the folder will be displayed like this. Okay, see E:\SAP NW701/exports, like that. You have to extract all, like installation master, extract all, and the installation master folder will be created within the E:\SAP NW701. Click on the extract and the installation master folder will be displayed like this. And then kernel folder, extract all, and it will be extracted into this extract. Don't confuse, actually I am just taking the screenshots only. Actually this will be the very easy process to extract each and every file. So how I am doing, in the same way you can also do very easily. Okay, next screen is, that is OCL. This OCL is not a zip file, just click right click and copy and paste it here. Copy and not only that, OCL and J2SDK, both you select and copy and paste it here. Okay, and next is Oracle 10G 2008 folder. under that two zip files will be there. One is for Oracle software, another is for Oracle patch. First Oracle software you extract all, and this is the Oracle software. The same numbers I left it off there, and click on the extract. So the Oracle software will be extracted into this particular folder 5103695, and then the patch extract all. And the 5104176_4 is the patch folder, and it also goes to the same folder, that is Oracle 10G2008 extract, and Oracle is also extracted. Now ready to start the prerequisites installation, that is J2 SDK installation should be started. This is the file available within the folder. Double click on that particular file, and the J2 SDK installation will be started. Click on the next, click on the next, click on the finish, and so that J2 SDK installation is completed. And here the C:J2 SDK folder will be created. Go to that particular folder and right click on J2 SDK 1.4. and click on the copy address, so that the folder path will be copied into your mouse clipboard. Means you have to paste it in the environment variables. That's why I am showing you how to copy the address from here. Click on that and go to right click on computer, click on the properties, and click on advanced system settings, and click on the environment variables. Click on the new button here, type java_home, and right click here and paste it, so that the mouse clipboard, whatever the content contains, that will be pasted here. C:J2SDK. Click on the OK button and choose the path from the system variables. Click on the edit button and path, and you paste, just select anywhere here and hit home key from your keyboard, so that cursor will come to the starting point and it will blink there. So that right click and paste, the content which are stored in your mouse clipboard will be pasted, and put slash here and type the bin and put semicolon. Okay, click on the OK, click on the OK, click on the OK, and then now click on the advanced tab and choose adjust for best performance. Okay, and click on the advanced, and now you will see virtual memory setting, that is click on the change button and remove this particular tick and put 25,000 and 30,000. It is 20 GB is minimum for the installation of SAP network software, and this is actually virtual memory from the hard drive. Means the hard drive space will act as a RAM, so that this specification, this requirement is compulsory. It is prerequisite for SAP network software installations, so that you put 25,000 and as minimum initial size, and maximum size is 30 GB, and click on the set, so that the set, whatever the settings you have done here, that will come here, 25,000 to 30,000. Click on the OK, and now click on the OK. In this screen you see total paging file size for all drives is 25,000 MB, means 25 GB. Click on the OK, and now click on the computer name. You have to change the computer name, means this computer name is taken by the VMware installation. Automatically you have to choose the proper naming convention. You should have 13 characters maximum length for the computer name. So I have given the computer name as SAP NW701 here. Click on the more button, and this is the DNS primary suffix. I have provided punarvasi.com as it is my own website domain name. You can use your domain name, or even non-existing domain name also you can provide. Something dot something should be there. Click on the OK button. Okay, and click OK here, and click OK here, and it will ask you to restart the computer. Click close, click on the restart computer, and now send control alt delete again. It will be restarted. Once you it is restarted, it will comes to this particular screen and it will stop. Again send control alt delete, and you can log on to the system, and you can directly start the installation of Oracle from this directory E:SAP NW701 Oracle 10G2008 5103695 NT ADM 64. You will see this type of file, that is SAP server.cmd file it is. Just double click on that particular file to start the Oracle installation. And you will see this black screen. From here you have to choose the drive letter where you want to install the SAP network, where you want to install the Oracle software, C drive. I want to install complete SAP software within the C drive, so that even database software also I am installing in the C drive only. Okay, hit enter and it will ask you to enter the system identifier, that is 3 alphanumeric characters you should provide, and the alphanumeric character should start with the alphabet and then number, and the all three letters should looks like this. I have chosen DEV and hit enter so that the Oracle installation will be started like this. Click on the install button to start the installation. So once the installation is completed, end of installation, click on the exit button and click on the yes button. Now Oracle software is installed, you have to apply the patch to it. To apply the patch, you have to stop Oracle service, so that click on the start and click on the run button and type services.msc command here. Click on the OK and go to Oracle service and right click here and click on the stop. Click on the stop so that the service will be stopped. And now just open the patch folder, that is SAP NW701. So and so here, this is the disk one, and you can easily find out this particular location. Just double click on the setup, and this is the initial screen you will see. Click on the next. Here something will be there. You have to choose this. You have to click on this arrow mark here so that the Oracle home will be selected like this, DEV102, and the path also will be displayed automatically, C:\Oracle Dev 102 by default path where the Oracle actual installation go installed, so that the path will be selected like this. Click on the next button. So the patch will be applied to the existing Oracle software, and click on the next button. There is no need to provide any email ID. Just click on the yes so that the this screen will be displayed. Click on the next button. Click on the install and the patch will be applied in few minutes. Okay, click on the exit. Click on the yes button and go to services again. Whatever the services you have stopped before applying Oracle patch, you have to start that particular service. And the Oracle software is installed and it is patched. Now ready to start the SAP network software installation from the location of E:\SAP NW701 installation_master. This is the folder install and IM_Windows_x86_64, and select the double click on SAP inst file, this double click on it so that the installation SAP network software delivery tool will be started. And this is the screen where you have to choose your SAP product. The SAP product which you are going to install is SAP Network 7.0 including enhancement package 1 support release 1. You have to choose the Oracle software because you are planning to install the software on top of Oracle. If you are planning to install on top of MS SQL Server, you have to install the MS SQL software already in the system, so that you can choose this option. Even MaxDB, IBM DB2, whatever the database you want to install this SAP software on, the particular database software should be selected from this tree. In my case, I have chosen Oracle and central system. In central system means all the database instance, central instance, everything will goes into the single system. Choose the central system option here, click on the next, and choose the typical option, click on the next, and it will ask you to log off one time. Click on the OK, it will be logged off. Once you click on the control or delete and enter the password, the installation will be started automatically. Provide the password, hit enter, the installation starts automatically. Again, there is no need to choose the SAP inst file. Okay, and this is the screen where you have to provide the SAP system ID. It is abbreviated as SAP SID DEV, DEV. I have provided the DEV for Oracle software installation also. Same DEV I am providing here. Even you can choose different one, there is no problem. and this is SAP SID. Again click on the next, provide the password, master password, master password, and confirm the password. It is the password will be used for logging into the SAP system for first time using DDIC user as SAP star user, and click on the next. Here database ID, DBS ID, DEV. Earlier I have chosen DEV for the Oracle software installation, but in this case this is the database SID, means the database will be created in the database software. And even for the database SID also I have provided the same SID, system identifier. You can choose different one here. Click on the next and choose the installation export. Click on the browse and choose the exports folder in the E drive where you have extracted the files, and click on the OK. Click on the next and choose the kernel folder by clicking on the browse, and Oracle client by clicking on the browse. Okay, and SAP cryptography file also will be asked. Actually I have not stored the cryptography file previously, so that the cryptography file I have copied from my other computer and pasted here, and the same will be is pasted within the equivalent drive where we have copied all the software, and I have chosen this particular file here. Click on the next, and this is the parameter summary screen. From here you can check all the parameters. If you want to change some parameter setting from here, even if you want to change the system identifier from here, you can choose this option and click on the revise button to change the SAP SID. And I have chosen something here, you see, just here Oracle will be installed within the redo log archives will goes into the E drive, because the E drive is available within this VM. That's why it has taken E drive as the destination for redo log archives. Actually I don't want to spread anything from this C drive, because I want to take the backup of the VMDK file itself so that I can reuse it whenever I want. Means I have forgotten to explain you about the backup thing after completion of the Oracle. Just before this screen, once the Oracle software is installed and patched, what you can do is you can go to your virtual machines folder, which will be created within your user account in your host operating system. That .vmdk file you can copy and paste it somewhere, so that you can start your SAP installation from this SAP inst onwards. Okay, I hope you understood. If you don't understand, just leave your comment so that I will explain in my comments in the YouTube channel. Okay, and choose all E drives here. Just I have chosen this option. Click on the revise button and choose all E drives into C drives. Here also E drives will be there. All you make it as C drive and click on the next. Again you will see parameter summary screen, and here you have to click on the next button. Okay, and it will ask you to provide the solution manager key, and for these values this is the solution manager key. Provide the solution manager key, and the solution manager key will be generated using the solution manager system. And I have already generated this particular key and pasted it here. Okay, click on the next button and the installation will be started like this. Okay, all these pages should be completed. It will take approximately 2 to 3 hours time for the completion. Actually ECC at this stage, ECC software will take almost 20 hours installation, but because it is only SAP Netware software, so that it will be finished very fast. Okay, and particularly this import ABAP stage, even in the case of ECC installation also, import ABAP stage will take much time, like approximately 20 hours time it will take. Here 1 hours to 1.5 hours time it will take, it will be finished. You see completed 2, and I have taken the screenshot that stage of completed 28, and after that I have taken the screenshot when it is checking the DDIS password, and I have taken final screenshot of successful completion. Click on the OK button so that the main phase of SAP Netware software is installed. Means the SAP Netware 7.0 HP1 is completely installed properly without having any errors. Okay, so once this is the once it is over, it is time for extracting the SAP GUI software. Actually SAP GUI software is this 5100 something is there, and you extract that particular file also into your E drive, /sap_nw701. This is the folder. Click on the extract. Once it is extracted, you can go through this particular folder path. From here, double click on setup all to install the SAP front end installer. Click on the next, select all, click on the next, and this will goes into this particular folder, and the business explorer also will goes into the this particular folder. Click on the next and click on the close, so that SAP logon is available on the desktop to log on to the SAP system. Double click on it and right click here, connect under connections, right click here and click on the click on the add new entry and click on the next, and provide the description like this. Whatever the description you want to provide here, you can provide. And application server is this, that is SAP NW701, means host name of the virtual machine, and the instance number and system ID is DEV. Click on the finish and you will get the option like this. Just double click on it, this option, to log on to the SAP system. And 001 is the default client and user is DDIC. Password, whatever the password you have provided while starting the installation, that is master password, provide the password, hit enter, and you will get this type of screen. It will work for 1 month's time, and click on the continue button here so that you can see SAP easy access screen. So this bigger screen looks like this. Okay, that's all. I hope you understood very well about installing SAP NetWare 7.0 EHP1, including installation of VMware Workstation, Oracle, J2 SDK and all prerequisites. Thank you. You can become my private list of subscriber to watch 102 videos currently available and all the future videos up to 1 year from this particular link. Thanks for watching.